Olá, senhoras e senhores, meu nome é Arthur Eloy. Eu tô aqui em Dallas hoje esperando o meu voo para Los Angeles porque eu vou assistir Nós, ou Us, novo filme de Jordan Peele. Eu acho que o Jordan Peele, ele é um dos caras mais interessantes fazendo terror agora porque ele representa bastante o movimento que tá tendo dentro do terror, que são pessoas de outro gênero que estão se aventurando e acabam se apaixonando por isso. E eu também vou entrevistar ele, vou conversar com o elenco, então vai ser bem da hora. Então me acompanha que eu vou mostrar tudo pra vocês. Tô dando uma voltinha aqui por Los Angeles, nessas horinhas que eu tenho livre, antes de voltar. Uma coisa que eu acho legal é como essa cidade é realmente apaixonada por entretenimento, o que é se esperar, né? É legal que você vê tipo umas billboards muito, muito, muito grandes de filmes e séries que tem outdoors enormes, assim, pegam tipo prédios inteiros ou colossais. Você vê também que tem vários prédios históricos dos estúdios, então isso é uma coisa bem legal pra quando você for dar uma voltinha pela cidade. Tô aqui em Los Angeles, especificamente no Chinese Theater, cinema icônico de Hollywood, porque eu acabei de assistir Nós, o que é impressionante, bizarríssimo. Eu ainda preciso de tempo pra processar, mas eu gostei bastante do que eu vi.
Can I help you?
Zora. Put your shoes on.
If you want to get crazy, we can get crazy. What are you people?
Eu não vou entrar aqui muito nas impressões, mas ó, sabe o que eu tô aqui hoje? Pra entrevistar o Jordan Peele, o diretor, e a Lupita Nyong'o, o Winston Duke, então vai ser muito legal, vou mostrar tudo pra vocês.
It's such an honor talking to you.
Thank
and I gotta say I love the fact that after Get Out you went head first into the horror genre, doing stuff like Candyman, The Twilight Zone reboot and all Us. So, what do you think that is so interesting in the horror genre?
You know, I think it's one of the most powerful genres for me because I think if you submit to the horror genre, you have better tools to deal with your own fears. And, you know, that's what we are as human beings. And I think so often our fears betray us. They cause us to make the wrong decision. Mm-hmm. So, I think it's an important genre for that reason.
E agora acho que dá pra dizer com muita certeza que eu gostei bastante do que eu vi. Eu acho que o Jordan Peele é um caso muito interessante, porque se você parar pra pensar que Corra é o primeiro filme de terror dele, vendo agora Nós, você percebe que ele já tinha um estilo muito, muito bem definido do que ele queria fazer. E, cara, isso é ótimo. Tipo, ele tem uma combinação única de três elementos que... É, combinar essa violência gráfica com comédia e com comentário social. E agora em Nós tá em simplesmente outro nível.
Não. Não. Não, 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 não.
And what makes it so great for political and social commentary?
If it works, it's because it's working on a couple of different levels. Mm-hmm. You know, some of the great horror movies, Night of the Living Dead, you know, Halloween, The Birds, they are about something greater than what they're about. And the audience doesn't necessarily know it, but in their reaction, I think it generates a sort of catharsis that, like I said, it gives them the tools to explore why is this affecting me? Mm-hmm.
Well, I think it's a very creative way of doing that because it makes it palatable for people to take in those kinds of themes and messages.
I feel we get to interrogate where our monsters come from and what they look like and where our fears come from. And with our movie, we're diving right into that. We're diving into the other. We're diving into what scares us and holding a mirror up to society and saying maybe it looks a lot more like you.
And the movie seems balances horror and the comical few jokes? How was on the set with so many jokes going around?
I think that Winston was definitely the comical relief during the movie because, you know, you don't really want just a horror movie with, you know, just horror. You know, you want something to let you down a little bit easy so that you're not aware when the scare actually comes. So I think that really helped, you know, pull the movie all together.
Eu gostei muito da Lupita Nyong'o, principalmente falando que ela ficou traumatizada por Mártires, né? Que é um... Todo mundo que já assistiu Mártires sabe que não é um filme de terror fácil. O Jordan Peele passou uma listinha pra ela de 10 filmes de terror pra ela assistir e entender o personagem dela. Você pode conferir no site Omelete, inclusive, tem a notícia lá.
How was the preparation to do a horror movie? I heard that Jordan Peele sent you a list of movies for reference. How was that?
Yeah, he sent me a list of 10 films to watch, and with each film he gave a little blurb, and it was like a progression of kind of scary to you're gonna lose your mind, kind of scary. And the last one said, enter at your own risk.
Whoa. Which one was it?
It was called Martyrs.
Oh, that's great. The French one? Not the remake?
It's not. Is it French? No, it was... I feel like it was English, but I actually don't know. I don't even remember what language I watched it in, but it was messed up. I can't remember. Is it French?
Yes. But it is really, really scary.
Yeah, it's really messed up.
To be honest, it wasn't really... preparation to do a horror movie was preparation to do a Jordan Peele film.
Yeah, how was working with Jordan Peele on the set?
No, he's the best. I think that he's definitely one of my favorite directors that I've worked with so far. And I think that he's just so professional, and he was really specific about how he wanted the movie to be. And I think that, you know, he helped us a lot through the process, and just the environment that he created for us was really great.
It was fantastic. He's such a cool person to be around. He's even keeled. He has a vision. He knows what he wants, but he welcomes you into his mind, and he allows you to play openly, and he's open to suggestions, and the best idea wins. And yeah, it was fun. He's funny. He's protective. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was so much fun to work with him.
Dessa vez ele usa essa coisa bizarra dos doppelgangers, né, dos clones, pra discutir privilégio. E eu acho que é bem eficiente, porque ele faz de uma forma que tá tão intrínseco com a caracterização do vilão que é fácil de entender. Apesar dele não ficar levantando bandeira pro tema, tipo, não deixando na cara sobre o que ele tá falando, é um tema que você entende por associação, sabe?
Did Get Out critics shaped us in any way?
You know, I definitely came out of Get Out wanting to make a clear horror film. Now I have my own brand of horror, but you know, I wanted to make a monster movie.
Yeah.
and that was kind of the clearest definition I could say, okay, I'm making an offering to my favorite genre.
Ele não se leva tanto como um filme de mensagem, ele não é tanto um filme que quer te ensinar sobre um assunto como ele é um filme de terror. Ele é definitivamente um filme de terror, ele é redondinho. E se você quiser assistir sem pensar muito, você consegue, mas como ele usa muitas dessas metáforas, eu acho que é muito, muito difícil você não sair de cinema sem se perguntar o que você viu.
How do you guys come up with the body language for your shadow versions?
We would talk a lot about how he wanted to portray the characters on screen, but he gave us a lot of freedom with moving around and like how to, you know, how to stand and how to walk and, you know, use our body language to really scare the audience.
And you?
I don't know.
Yeah.
originally, I was gonna do a stance in like this way, but then like I actually started doing Pluto more often. That I had made up a little stance for him where he could literally jump at anyone and just kill him.
Yeah.
By the throat.
Yeah.
Early on, Jordan said to me of her and what he wanted to experience in her physicality is that she was a queen and a cockroach. And so those two things, though they seem like complete opposites, they have a lot in common. Both of them can be quite still and also quite menacing. There's a regality to a queen and a resilience to a cockroach. And So the cockroach word was very helpful for me because, you know, a cockroach can stay real still and then it scurries and, you know, and it will survive, you know. And so those kinds of things were very, very helpful in like kind of grounding me and giving me the start of a vocabulary for her.
They look exactly like us. They think like us. They know where we are.
And how was working with Lupita and Winston? Because you guys have such a close connection to,
right.
Working with Lupita was really cool because seeing how she would get into character was really helpful. Like, when she was doing her exercises before a scene, me and Shahadi would do them.
Yeah.
Because I was like, we should do that so we can be good actors like she is.
Yeah, it was great.
Because
yeah.
She's such a great actor that she put so much into this movie that it blew my mind away.
I just talked to the kids and they're really great, but they were really, really scary in a movie. So
yeah.
I was working with them because you have such a close connection in the
yeah,
movie.
It was wonderful. What we had a rehearsal process before we started filming where we just went to the house we were gonna be, you know, quote unquote, living in, and we got to know each other. We got to play around and just like figure out our chemistry, and that was so helpful because by the time we started shooting, we kind of knew each other. And yeah, they were so present, so ready to play, you know, and just, and also absorbent. And it was great to work with kids like that.
So thank you for having me.
Okay, take care.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
So much, man. Awesome.
Senhoras e senhores, depois de finalmente ter conversado com o Jordan Peele, ter entrevistado o elenco, ter assistido Nós, é hora de me despedir. Eu já tô aqui no aeroporto de Los Angeles esperando meu voo pra São Paulo. Vou voltar pra casa querendo assistir o filme de novo. Eu quero muito ver a reação das pessoas a esse filme. Mas eu também vou voltar, ó, usando o blusão que eles deram pra gente. Tem o logo, tem uma tesourinha em algum lugar aqui dele. E ele é bem quentinho e vai ajudar bastante no ar-condicionado do avião. Então, novamente, muitíssimo obrigado por ter acompanhado. Muitíssimo obrigado, Universal. E deixa aqui nos comentários o que você tá esperando aí do filme. Se você já assistiu, não faço ideia de quando esse vídeo vai ao ar. Mas até a próxima.